So we've all been there, right? You empty the trash on your Mac and you freeze. How do you get your files back, like, right now? Well, today we're covering just that, how to recover files and data from your trash bin on your Mac after you've emptied it. And by the way, if you get any value out of this video at all and you want to see more, let me know by leaving a like and comment down below in the comment section. I really appreciate it. All right, let's get started. So there's really two ways to frame this problem. First, you could rely on data backups with something like Time Machine, for example. If you take the time to back up your data on a daily basis, and this is arguably the best way to go about any kind of data recovery. However, if you don't use Time Machine, then file recovery software becomes your next best chance at getting your files back. So jumping right in here to option number one, we're going to be starting with file recovery software, and that is going to be using a piece of software called Disk Drill. And when it comes to data recovery software, Disk Drill is almost always at the top of my list, and that's for good reason. It's fast, easy to use, and powerful enough to get us the results that we're looking for. Not to mention, the latest iteration of Disk Drill, Disk Drill 5, comes fully optimized for the latest OS, macOS Ventura, and older Macs alike. So pretty much no matter what you're running, you're covered. It allows you to scan any drive, preview files before you actually recover them, and even see recovery chances of a particular file before upgrading to the Pro version. However, with Disk Drill or any other piece of file recovery software that you're using, it is mission critical that you avoid using the drive that contains the deleted files as much as possible to avoid overwriting the files, because this will basically nullify all of our attempts to get them back. Installing it to just an external USB device, such as a simple thumb drive, can be a really unique way to kind of get around that issue. Okay, so to recover files from an empty trash bin on your Mac, here's what you do. So go ahead and download and install Disk Drill to your Mac. Then once it's installed, open it up and you'll be presented with the disk list. Then select the drive that contained the emptied trash bin and start the scan. All right, but once the scan is complete, you can go ahead and review all the files that were recovered during the scan. You want to make sure that these files are intact by previewing them and so on and so forth. This will give you the best chance of a complete recovery. But after that is the case, go ahead and select them, then click Recover, and choose your save location. Again, please note, if possible, do not save the files to the same location that you're trying to recover from, even your main hard drive or SSD that is in your Mac. So if you can, try and save them to an external USB device. It's really important. All right, then once that's done, hit OK, and that will complete the recovery. So that is option one, and the better of the two, if you ask me. But let's move on to option two, which is going to be using a free piece of software again called PhotoRec. So albeit not as ironclad as Disk Drill, it still offers some serious elbow grease in the file recovery department, and it's definitely worth a shot. The only downside here is that this software's user interface is not quite as polished as some others out there. And while this definitely isn't like a deal breaker at all, there definitely will be a bit of a learning curve which can hinder some of the results in the interim. All right, and finally, to round out this video, let's talk about restorative options. So there are two main classifications of these. One would be direct backup, and the second would be what I like to call third-party coverage. So first, covering Time Machine backups, this is probably my preferred and favorite, but obviously only applies if you have ever made a legit Time Machine backup at some point in the past. But if you have, then just connect the drive to your Mac, then load up Time Machine, search for the file in their previous original locations, then select the file you want to restore, and hit Recover to save it once more to your hard drive or your solid state drive. And restoring from a third-party backup is just as easy, albeit not quite as secure as Time Machine. Using iCloud as my example, you can just navigate to your backup on the iCloud website and restore them from a previous save point there. And so that's it. That is how you recover files, data, photos, videos, documents, whatever it might be, from an emptied trash bin on your Mac. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video and that you got something out of it. And if you did, always be sure to leave us a like down below. Also, if you have any questions, comments, things you want me to cover in a future video, also be sure to let me know down below in the comment section. I always enjoy reading your guys' comments. But that is going to be it for today's video. My name is Andrew. Thank you for watching.